So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In this session guys, I will bring to you two important schemes from the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and the name of the schemes are guys Janani Suraksha Yojana and Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram. Okay, so let's begin with the session and let us first of all try to simplify the objective of Janani Suraksha Yojana. Okay. So guys, as the name suggests, what is the meaning of Janani? Janani means what? Mother. And Suraksha means what? Protection. So the government is intended to provide protection to the mothers. And how government can provide protection to the mothers? By providing them with the safe delivery. Okay, safe delivery agar mothers ko provide karai jayegi, then they will be protected. Okay, you can connect it like this, right? So for remembrance, for memorize the objective, you have to connect it somewhat. So let us connect it like this. So to provide the protection to the mother, the safe delivery has to be provided to the mother. And how can the government provide the safe delivery? By promoting the institutional deliveries. Okay, by promoting the institutional deliveries. So the basic objective is of this scheme is to reduce the maternal, and what will happen if we promote the institutional deliveries, the maternal and neonatal mortality rate will be reduced. Okay, jo maternal or neonatal mortality rate hai, that will be reduced if we promote the use of institutional deliveries. Alright. So the basic objective of this scheme is to reduce the maternal and neonatal mortality rate. Maternal and neonatal mortality rate. Neonatal mortality rate by promoting the institutional deliveries. So I hope guys the objective is clear. What is the objective? To reduce the maternal and neonatal mortality rate by promoting the institutional deliveries. Okay, so that's the objective. And now let's talk about the ministry. So ministry, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare ji honi chahiye, usme to koi doubt nahi hona chahiye, I guess. So the ministry is the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which is currently headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. But you have to confirm the name of minister before your exam. And if you talk about the funding, so guys, it is a central sector scheme. And if there is a scheme which is a central sector, then 100% funding is provided by the central government. Okay. And now let's talk about the benefits under this scheme. So institutional deliveries to promote karne ke liye, government is providing the financial assistance to the mothers. Financial assistance provide karai jaati hai to the mothers taki wo institutional deliveries ke liye, motivate ho. Okay. And who are the eligible beneficiaries to get this financial assistance? So if you talk about the low performing states, agar hum low performing states ki baat karte hain, so all pregnant women are eligible to get the benefit under this scheme who are seeking treatment in the government hospitals. So government hospital mein jane wali sabhi pregnant mahilaon ko is scheme ka fayda milta hai. Okay. And in the low performing state, all the SC, ST and BPL women, SC, ST and BPL women ke liye, agar wo accredited private hospitals mein jaati hain, to bhi unko ye benefit milta hai. Alright. Accredited private hospitals mein agar wo jayenge apna ilaaj karane, to bhi unko iska benefit milega. So for the low performing states, all the pregnant women who are visiting the government hospitals for the for their delivery, while for SC, ST and BPL accredited private hospitals mein bhi unko benefit milega. If we talk about the high performing states, so in the high performing states, only SC, ST and BPL women are provided the benefits. Okay, SC, ST and BPL women are provided with the benefits. Aur ye kahin pe bhi visit kar sakti hain, chahe wo government hospital ho ya fir accredited private hospital ho. Okay, accredited private hospital or the government health facility, kahin pe bhi agar jaake koi SC, ST ya BPL ki mahila high performing state mein apna delivery karati hai, then she will be eligible to get the financial assistance of this scheme. Okay. And talking about the financial assistance, guys, this financial assistance you have to remember. So in the low performing states, mother's package is 1400, while Asha's it is 600. So total it becomes 2000. While in the urban areas, 1000 for the mothers, Asha ke liye 400 and total it is 1400. If you talk about the high performing state, 700, 600, total 1300 milta hai in the rural areas, while in the urban areas, total is 1000. So just remember the total. You don't have to remember the bifurcations of this financial assistance. Just remember the total financial assistance in both the urban and rural areas for both the low performing and high performing states. Okay. So for low performing state in rural areas, total is 2000, while for high performing state, it is 1300. And in urban area, it is 1400 and 1000 respectively. Okay, so I hope guys this scheme is clear. इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा नहीं पढ़ना है. सो आई होप जननी सुरक्षा योजना इज क्लियर. सो जननी सुरक्षा योजना में क्या है, द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रमोटिंग द इंस्टीट्यूशनल डिलीवरी देयर बाय रिड्यूसिंग द मेटर्नल एंड नियोनेटल मॉर्टेलिटी रेट. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2015 अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर एंड सम फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस इज प्रोवाइडेड फॉर द प्रमोशन ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशनल डिलीवरीज. ओके एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट जननी शिशु सुरक्षा कार्यक्रम. So, what is the difference between Janani Suraksha Yojana and Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram? So, there is one more word that has been added. That is Shishu. And Shishu ka matlab kya hota hai? Child. So, here pe Janani and Shishu, yani ki mother and child, dono ke protection ki baat ki ja rahi hai. Okay? So, in this scheme, both mother and child are intended to be protected by the government of India through this scheme, jiska naam hai Janani शिशु सुरक्षा कार्यक्रम. ओके एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द ब्रॉड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्कीम देन अंडर दिस स्कीम गवर्नमेंट इज प्रोवाइडिंग कंप्लीटली फ्री एंड कैशलेस सर्विस टू द प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन इंक्लूडिंग नॉर्मल डिलीवरीज एंड सिजेरियन एंड फॉर दोज न्यू बॉर्न्स हु आर सिक. ओके अगर कोई बच्चा बीमार पैदा होता है देन दैट बच्चा विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ दिस स्कीम अप टू 30 डेज आफ्टर द बर्थ इन गवर्नमेंट हेल्थ इंस्टीट्यूशन इन बोथ अर्बन एंड रूरल एरिया. तो इसमें क्या है बेसिकली की मदर और चाइल्ड दोनों को प्रोटेक्शन प्रोवाइड कराई जाती है बाय द गवर्नमेंट. बोथ मदर एंड चाइल्ड आर प्रोवाइडेड प्रोटेक्शन बाय द गवर्नमेंट इफ द डिलीवरी हैज बीन डन इन द गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल इन बोथ अर्बन एंड रूरल एरिया एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज नो स्पेशल एलिजिबिलिटी फॉर दिस स्कीम. द एलिजिबिलिटी इज दैट द प्रेगनेंसी द डिलीवरी शुड बी डन इन द गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल. ओके just there is one eligibility that the delivery should be done in the government health facility. All right, and talking about the ministry, so the ministry is very clear, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare launch year iska aapko alag se yaad rakhne ki zarurat hai. Very important, 2011 mein launch hui thi, recent scheme nahi hai, bahut purani scheme hai, 9-10 saal ho chuke hain. So you have to remember the launch year of this scheme 2011 and beneficiaries ka, as I told you, all pregnant women who access government health facilities for their delivery are eligible to get the benefits. और इसमें benefit क्या है? The free and cashless service to the pregnant woman, either in the case of normal delivery or the cesarean. और उसका जो sick, अगर newborn sick है, तो उसको 30 days तक का इलाज free provide कराया जाएगा by the government. और इसमें ये भी होता है कि जो government है, is also providing the transportation facility to the woman from hospital to home or from the hospital or from her home to the hospital. Okay. So this is about this Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram and guys, I hope there is no confusion. So if you have to differentiate between these schemes, so first, जो उससे पहले पढ़ा हमने Janani Shishu Janani Suraksha Yojana, that was only for the mother for promoting the institutional deliveries, and this scheme is for both mother and child. If the child is born sick, then the child will be provided treatment by the government side up to the 30 days after the pregnancy. All right, so there is a clear cut difference between these two schemes. I hope the confusion is not more in your minds. So now let's talk about some questions guys that can be asked in your exam based on these two schemes. So isme se koi bahut alag sa question nahi aayega, most probably isme se jo question aayega that will be of this type only, where you have to identify the scheme. Okay, so let's talk about the question. A scheme to reduce maternal and neonatal mortality rate was launched in the year 2015. So as I told you in the questions, in these type of questions, the hints are given. So first of all, one hint is that the objective is given and the launcher is given. Okay, and then the ministry is also given, and there is one more hint. Under the scheme, financial assistance is provided to the eligible beneficiaries and ASHA workers. So we have to identify the scheme. So guys, this scheme is Janani Suraksha Yojana. Option A, Janani Suraksha Yojana, is the correct answer. And talking about the question number two, a scheme was launched in 2011 to provide completely free and cashless services to pregnant women, including normal deliveries and cesarean, and sick newborn up to 30 days after birth in government health institutions. So we have to identify the scheme again. So I hope you can easily identify the scheme. The scheme is what? Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram. That was launched in the year 2011. Okay. And guys, that's it for the scheme. I hope aapko ye dono scheme clear hai. So this week we have done three schemes: National Skill Development Mission, Janani Suraksha Yojana, and Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram. I hope all the three schemes are absolutely clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain next week kuch aur nayi scheme ke saath. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.